Today we are going to talk with this beautiful sunrise about working terriers. So the first question that is often asked, a working terrier, never heard of such a thing. This is a little bit silly a question for most of us, I think. But the working terrier exists at least from the 1440s. And terrier comes from terra, and which means earth. And also chien terrier was a French denotation to describe a dog for digging. So that's the name. And often before that they mention what kind of terrier it is, for example the quarry being a fox terrier, or an easy modern example in America, the red terrier. So it describes what they were bred to do, and also often denotes where they come from. For example, the Scottish terrier, the Lakeland terrier, etc. Also, there are many people who think that a working terrier must be a big dog, because they have to work, they cannot be that brittle. One, every working terrier is not a brittle type of dog, just to start it up. They are often extremely hardy, especially for their small size. That's one. And two, depending on the quarry that they were bred to hunt, normally a smaller dog would do better. One, by being easier to get to the quarry they need. Two, it takes a lot less effort for the dog to dig to the quarry, so it gets there fresh and with all its energy. And three, it also needs to have airflow that is not constricted in the den to prevent asphyxiation. So a too big a dog could lead to that easier. And then fourth, it's also a tactical benefit to not be too big, because then you can maneuver a lot better in the dens, and also being easier able to dodge the attacks of the quarry that they face. That being said, if a dog faces formidable quarry, which is often the case, if they are smaller than the quarry that they hunt, or the quarry is extremely capable, for example, European badger is an extremely capable adversary. One of the biggest tests a dog can have, regardless of size, then it does help that you have some size. And why? Take for example that European badger. If you have a too small a dog facing it, it will very likely be mauled and killed. And otherwise, what also is the case is often that too small a dog just gets overrun, so to say, and when it's down and it cannot escape, it will be made short work of by many a badger. Also big foxes, especially the big males, can cause extreme damage and also kill many a good terrier. This is a little bit controversial, because many people think that a fox is quite light work for a terrier, which is the case. But if you have a big fox in the right time of the year, and there's also a good den for it to fight, then it does occur even that the good terriers that they die. And it can be many a case. Also the den can collapse, leaving the dog obstructed there. It's not that the quarry must make the fatal damage to the dog. It can also be the environment. or all of the above. So they please take this into consideration. Then there are, in its essence, two types of working terrier. One is a working terrier that is made to make the fox bolt, for example. Let's just keep the example of the fox or other quarry, but especially the fox, it's easier to describe. And when the fox bolts, the hounds can be sent after it, or it can be shot, or it can be captured in a net. That's what happens next. And you also have a type of terrier that needs to keep the quarry at its place by, that's keeping it extremely busy, but also grabbing it. And you can imagine with that type of terrier, it will be very hard to escape, because it is not scared. Not saying that the baying type, bolting type of terriers are scared, but they do protect themselves a lot more and keep at a respectable distance often to the quarry, whereas the grabbing type of terriers, they just go in, all in, and will keep it or die trying. The type of terrier you see here is of the latter type, so grab and hold type of terrier, Labradoodle Terrier, also known as Fel Terrier. And then you have white fells and black fells. This is a black fell type of terrier. And also the fell describes what kind of terrier work it was. Fells are like rocky crevices, where, for example, very big type of foxes lived. And they were just sent in. It was almost impossible to dig to, if not completely impossible, on a dog. Needed to do its business without letting the fox escape. So another bolting type of terrier, because also you can imagine on those rocky crevices, rocky underground, will be very hard to chase a fox, which can also go to the next crevice again. But just a dog that goes in and kills the fox, mostly. I'm not saying they would never bolt, but the idea behind breeding this dog was a dog that would grab and hold and make short work of it. So, back to where were you standing. So there are two types of terriers. Yeah, the more the catch dog type of terrier, and the bolting baying type of terrier. Baying is another word for barking at it. So then this is also a benefit for many a hunter, that you know where the quarry is, where the dog is. Normally quarry and dog would be close to each other, and also the way the dog barks would give insight on what kind of quarry there is, if you have an experienced dog, and also if they make contact or not. So after that, if you have a confronting type of terrier, the digging starts. So the hunters help to dig and to get to the fox or badger or what other kind of quarry that is there at that location. Other types of quarry that are quite rising also in Europe are raccoon dog, which comes from Asia and is just increasing the area that they live in, and they also cover a big part of Europe. Also the raccoon, which came from fur farms and escaped from the USA, is now also present in Europe, and being a pest, it's also worked on. Same with nutria, which is like a gigantic rat that looks like a beaver, but it's still a rat. Also escape from fur farms, real pest. You also have other big types of rat that destroy dikes and other parts that we as humans made, especially muskrats. Of course, the normal rats, I already mentioned the rat terrier, but also other breeds especially Pattedale and Plummer Terrier are very good at this. They're also being used to hunt hawk, swine, feral pigs, but especially in Europe the swine. They bred different type of terriers for this work. Some terriers are also all-rounders, they do it all. For example, the German Jagd Terrier, German Hunting Terrier, which is done as a traditional type of terrier work. Let's describe terrier work. Terrier work is normally work underground, also known as digging. And that's the type of work a regular terrier would do. But for example, the Jagd Terrier is used as that type of dog for fox and badger, which is legal in Europe, but also used on the swine and other type of quarry. Okay, then the working terriers. I think the most used terrier next to the German Jagd Terrier, which is more an all-rounder, is the Pattedale Terrier that I have here. Also known as the Fell Terrier, the Black Fell Terrier, more specific. Oi oi. And another one is that the Border Terrier, which is more often a show dog than not, but they are still being worked. Has a little bit shorter nose, but there's also that catch dog type of style. And you also have dogs like the Lakeland Terrier, which is a very good working terrier. If they are from a working strain, normally also a show dog. And of course the Fell Terriers, which Pattedale is the most well known of, but there are different types, also white type of Fell Terriers. Another terrier that's seen some occasional work is the Plummer Terrier. This is a terrier primarily developed for hunting and killing rats. So no terrier work, no, it's on the ground of course, but they are sometimes used for some work on the ground as well. A big benefit might be that especially lately they are crossed a lot with the Pattedale Terriers, especially they also come in brown or red, and those reds are combined with the Plummer Terrier to give the broader genetic base, because the Plummer Terrier was developed by intense inbreeding. I thought even one the stud dog that they use, Vampire, in some animals, it was 9 times the stud dog. So the first combination, then that Vampire dog over its daughter, then the daughter thereof, his granddaughter, etc, etc, up to 9 times after each other, which you can imagine will bring enormous inbreeding on this specific type of dog, which was very good at its work. And that gives you some insight. But those dogs that I mentioned are all dogs from England, terriers, where the working terriers specifically come from this United Kingdom, of course, but also some terriers were developed in Germany lately, being this German Hunting Terrier, which is a very good all-rounder, which they use, of course, English terrier breeds to establish. And later on they also have a Westphalian Terrier, which is similar to the Jagd Terrier, but easier to handle. Also an option to keep in house, because it is very much more mellow and less aggressive and more easy to handle. And they also bred the Heide Terrier, but this is a dog. It's not a terrier in the original sense. It's never been bred to do earthwork. It's been bred to only hunt the hawk, the swine, feral pigs, that kind of work. And they are very good at it. So they increase the size, the strength, and also made them easier to handle than the German Hunter Terrier, also called Jacht Terrier. And Jacht is a German word for hunting. For me, the best or the nicest hunting terrier would be the one on the leash. It's the Battledore Terrier. Why? Because it's the specialist. Underground is also a relaxed type of dog, because it is a confronting style, not the baying style, which I like a lot more. Not too vocal, and if they are vocal, then there's something amiss. And also I like the temperament in house, because they are all terriers, all working terriers can be quite rowdy. And also ambitious, boisterous. That's the right word, sorry for that. But the Patterdale Terriers, and even more so the Border Terriers, also have an off switch. A little bit better, so they can be kept in the house. Whereas the other extreme would be the German Jacht Terrier, or the German Hunting Terrier, which is, in my opinion, not a dog to be kept in the house. They are always busy. Even till their feet are bleeding against the fence. Some hunters say that you don't even have to take them out for walks, because they exercise themselves. But that's not a type of hoy. Not the type of dog that, in my opinion, should be kept in house. I'm not saying it's impossible, but because it is possible, of course. But you must really think clear here. And in my opinion, even if it's possible, one should think at what cost and how does it compare to other types of dogs. The benefit of the German Jacht Terrier, of course, is that if you want an all-rounder type of hunting dog, then they might be the better choice. That being said, also the quarry that the Patterdale has not been developed for example, the swine, you see, a big influx lately by the Heide Terrier, but also Patterdales to help the hunting of swine. And they can be like miniature catch dogs, so that's they are even braver than your Jacht Terrier, and also are less quarrelsome, so they won't fight among each other that much, which is also a big benefit. The Heide Terrier brings it with a big type of dog, but these small little missiles can also help. And the third reason could be that especially where they have feral pigs or they hunt swine to also get a source of meat, the little ones, if you catch them with a Patterdale Terrier, sustain a lot less damage and can be raised and fattened up so that they grow a lot. And then being slaughtered at a later stage, so that they get more meat for their hunting prowess. So that was that. I hope you liked this video. I tried to cover all topics that I was thinking about. Please let me know if you see some topics missed, and I can make another video about that. Have a nice day. Bye bye.